Hey everybody, what's up? It's Rob Dodson, and in today's episode of Polycasts, we're going to be picking up where we left off last time with the core header panel. We're going to take that mobile site that we started to build, and we're going to incorporate one more element called core drawer panel, so we can get an experience that looks really great both on our desktop and on our mobile device. So let's dive in. So this is where we left things off in our last video. We've got this site that looks really great on our mobile device, but on our desktop, it's just a little stretched out. I mean, I'm not even showing my browser at full width here. What I'd like to do is to add a sidebar over here on the left, and that way our content is just going to look a little bit nicer. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a core drawer panel, which is a responsive container that combines a side drawer with a main content area. Now, any content that you place in the drawer panel that you give a drawer attribute to is going to actually end up over here in your sidebar. Likewise, any content that you have a main attribute on is going to end up in your main area. Now, the cool thing about the drawer panel is that it's actually responsive by default. And so that means that on smaller screens, it knows to move the drawer out of the way. And then we can just wire it up to something like a hamburger menu to display that drawer again when someone clicks on it. Now, by default, the drawer panel is going to collapse when it's at about 640 pixels. And so if we want to change that behavior, we can give it a responsive width attribute and set the responsive width to a different value. For instance, we could set it equal to like 800 pixels if we would prefer it to collapse at that size. Now, you might be wondering, how does the drawer panel actually know where to render its children? So let me show you a little example. Over here on the left, we have the markup that we've been working with. You can consider this our light DOM. In the center here, we've got the kind of abbreviated source for the core drawer panel itself. We can say this is our shadow DOM. And over here on the right, we've got a rendering of what our final page is going to look like. So notice these content elements inside of the drawer panel. These are what are known as insertion points. And what insertion points do is they actually invite content from the light DOM over into the shadow DOM. This is done through a process that is known as distribution. You can think of distribution kind of like pointing a movie projector at a wall. So what we're doing is we're actually taking the content from our drawer element here, and it's being projected into the shadow DOM, just like you would project video content at a wall. And that's being displayed over here in our drawer area. Likewise, with this main element, it's being projected into the shadow DOM, and that gets rendered as our primary content. Now, the cool thing here is that you can have all sorts of markup and CSS and whatever you want in the shadow DOM that frames these elements. So we can create really complex structures in the shadow DOM and then take advantage of them in the light DOM just by using a few lines of HTML. I think that's really powerful. So over in our code editor, the first thing I'm going to do is open up the elements HTML file, and I'm going to import the definition for the tags that we're going to be using in this example. So I'm going to import the core drawer panel, I'm going to import the core menu, and I'm going to import the core item. Now back in my index.html file, I'm going to create a core drawer panel element, and then I'm just going to grab this header panel right here and actually move it up into my drawer panel. And I got to remember to include that main attribute, and that way it's going to render as our primary content. I'm going to ditch the flex attribute because the drawer panel is going to handle laying this element out for us. I'm also going to create a second header panel inside of here, and this is going to be the content that goes into our drawer. So I've got to make sure to give it a drawer attribute, and then I'm going to just create a toolbar inside of here, and we'll say, give it a title of something like menu. And then below that, we'll throw in that core menu element that we imported, and we'll create two menu items inside of here. We'll just give each of these a label that will represent the different pages in our site, so we'll say one and two. Now we're going to add some CSS and JavaScript to our application, but first I want to go down here to our core icon button, and I want to give it an ID of nav icon. That's just going to make it a lot easier to work with later on. I'm also going to go up to my core drawer panel and give it an ID of drawer panel. Now over in our app CSS, I'm just going to paste in a few styles, and you know, some pretty typical stuff. We're setting a background color. You know, we're setting another background color in our drawer panel. But there's this really interesting style down here at the bottom where I'm saying when the core drawer panel is not narrow, the nav icon should be display none. So what does that mean exactly? Well, if we hop over to the documentation and we scroll down to the attribute section for the core drawer panel, you'll see that there's this narrow attribute right here. And basically what happens with the narrow attribute is when the drawer panel is collapsed, the narrow attribute gets set to true and it ends up showing up on the tag. When the drawer panel is at full size, the narrow attribute gets removed. So basically, what our CSS is saying right here is hide the hamburger menu when we're expanded, and then show it when we're collapsed. It moves out of the way, and that hamburger icon appears up there in the top left. And if we stretch things out again, you'll see that the hamburger menu is hidden and the drawer panel slides back out. Pretty cool. Now, there's one missing piece here. When I click the hamburger menu, I want the drawer to actually slide back out. So how are we going to go about that? Well, we hop back into the documentation, and if we scroll down to the methods section, you see that there's a toggle panel method here, which allows us to toggle the panel open and closed. So in our application, we're going to create a new file called app.js. And then inside this file, I'm just going to paste in a little bit of JavaScript, and I'll walk you through what's going on here. We're first listening for the Polymer ready event. That way, we're guaranteed that all of our elements have upgraded and they're ready to rock. We're taking the nav icon in the drawer panel that we gave IDs to earlier. And we're telling the nav icon to listen to any click events. And when it hears a click event, it should tell the drawer panel to toggle open. So if we preview this in our application, click the hamburger, opens the drawer, and we can mess around with our menu buttons if we want. And clicking the gray area collapses it again. So just like that, we have a fully responsive website. And we only had to write a tiny bit of CSS and JavaScript. I think that's pretty awesome. In the next episode, I'm going to show you one weird trick to spice up your core drawer panel. And after that, we're going to start wiring this up with some real content. So as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.